Ladies and gentlemen, this is your favorite animal scientist, Mr. Kester Amos. We are here in Ogun State, a place called Oke-Ore, and we are building snail, poultry, and pig farms here, three in one. So actually what we're doing now is we are completing the concrete pens. What we are doing at the moment is we are plastering it and also showing the carpenter how to cover the pens. So even in our absence, they can do a perfect job. So you can see this is the first one and the carpenter just rounded off with this. So it's perfect. So with this now, it will be a platform for him to continue with the rest. So that is why you see that while they are still plastering, this one is already covered. We have done this so that even in our absence, they can continue with the work. While the plastering is done, they will officially continue with the carpentry work. So you can see how neatly it is built. So you just come along and you see what we have here. So it's quite a big project. This one is about, I think, Mr. Allah, how many pens do we have here?
109.
109.
Okay, we have 109 pens here and two greenhouses. So we're gonna do the breeding here just like normal from our previous videos. You must have seen that. So the breeding stock will be introduced here, and once they lay and we incubate the eggs and they hatch, we'll move them to the greenhouses. So here we have the greenhouse. We're having two greenhouses here. So you can see this is one and this is the second one. So we are done with the framework. So what is left is for them to plaster the block work. And after plastering and everything is made smooth, then we'll come for the covering of the greenhouse with the mesh and every other thing that needs to be put in place in the greenhouse. So basically, this is what it is like, the skeleton of the greenhouse. So we have done it in a way that after the plastering, we can just come over and cover it in order for us to have a very neat job. So this is the part for the snail farm. Down there, we'll be moving to the poultry. I will show you the poultry structures and also the pig farm. So we'll just take you down to that location for the pig and poultry. These are the poles we'll be using in the piggery section. So we are moving away from the snail section. You can see the greenhouses. So we have the poles that will be used for the piggery. So down there is the poultry structure. You can see the poles for the poultry are already standing. So we'll just show you how it is designed and we'll take you to the piggery. Okay, so this is the broiler section. The broiler house is measuring 30 feet by 200 feet. So the land is slopy, it's not a flat land, so we have also stepped it down two times. So we'll be having three different structures, three different partitions for the broiler house. So it affords us the opportunity of raising different sets of beds within this single structure. So if you look at this now, this is the first part. Okay, we'll go like this. Okay, so this is the first level. You can see it is higher. This is where we have the highest level. So at about 70 feet, we stepped it down. So this is the first step down. So we're having a section here. So this will be one cell or room or compartment. So when you come down, now this is the second compartment. So it's a long structure. It's 30 feet by 200 feet. So on the length, we have demarcated it into three. So this is one, and So this is the second one. So you can see we had to do a lot of feeding in order to cut down on cost. That's one of the reasons why we stepped it down. So if we had not stepped it down, the amount of feeding we'll have to do on this part to get it to this level will be too much. And that will be complete wastage of material. So that is why we have stepped it down into three different levels. So we'll block it at every step so we can have different breeds of birds. We can actually use the extreme for brooding and have the most mature sets of birds on the other extreme. So the center could be a barrier at some point when you have day-old chicks and mature birds. So we have a distance of over 50 feet demarcating between the day-old and the mature birds. So it depends on how we want to regulate the production. If we want to have all broilers all year round, we can have them all three sets can be coexisting in the structure. While we are brooding for chicks, points of lay pullets, we can have them at one extreme and have the day old or broiler in the other extreme. So the center becomes a buffer to keep away that distance from the two sets of birds. So that's the way it's designed. So this is the second compartment, and we have the third one here. So this is the third level. So you can see we are going to block it from here and build this one separate again. So we have three different levels, which will be three different compartments. So this is for broilers. Now you can, if you look over there, we have the one for the layers. We'll just move you over to the layer section and show you exactly what it looks like. This is my engineer, Engineer Ola. He's actually doing a very good job on the site. All right, so yeah, here we have our layers section. This is the layer building. Now, if you look at it, we have three rows. We'll be having three rows of cages as opposed to the regular two rows. This is the first row. We're using foreign cages. So the cage, the pit is measuring 2.2 meters. So this is the first. Then between this, you have the wall here. This pole should be extended to this point. So when you come here, you can see the distance between the perimeter block and the first pit. So the egg collector stands here to pick from the cages on this side. So when you move like this, you have a 2 meter space to play with. So between these, this is the perimeter block, and this is the first edge of the cage. So you have this space to walk around. Now, this is the center. This is the center between the first cage and the middle cage. So we'll have the middle cage here, the first cage here, and the third one will be on the other extreme. So that is how it is designed. This is the first phase of the work. So hopefully, by the time we come back with the next video, you'll get a clearer picture of how this design is done. All right, so this is the other walkway partition between the extreme left cage and the middle cage. So we have three rows of cages that will be running here. So this building is designed to carry 5,000 layers. So that's the design for it. And this is the partition where you have the perimeter block and this cage. So it's a fine design. You may have seen it, but the most popular design is two rows of cages. But this is not always common, three rows in a structure. So we are actually designing this with three rows. So by the time we finish with this, you want to see it. So it's actually what we're doing currently here. So we'll move you over to the last part of the project, which is the pig farm. We are also doing a pig farm, a big one too. So we have poultry, Broilers and Layers, 5,000 each, and about 200,000 capacity snail farm, and also over 3,000 capacity piggery. So we'll take you to the pig section now. All right, so this is the piggery section. From where I'm standing to the wall over there is the length of the pig structure. So if you look closely, it's actually getting dark, it's quite late. So if you look down, you will see the partitions. We've just created the trenches. We have not laid any blocks yet, but by the time we lay the blocks, you will see a clear view of it. So this is the design for it. We'll have breeder pens, and we'll have pens for weaners. So the breeder pens is where we'll have the mature pigs, where you have the boa, the sow, or the goat, as the case may be, where we do the breeding. And then we have the farrowing pens, where the female that is due for parturition, due for giving birth, will be moved into a special pen we call the farrowing pen, and she delivers there, stays with her young piglets there until the time for weaning. That is the separation period. So we take the young ones, the weaners, to the weaners pen. So this is the walkway. Where I'm standing is the walkway. So we'll have pens on the right and on the left. So we design the left side for the breeding pens and farrowing pens, while the whole of the right hand side will be designed for the weaners, because you don't need so much sows and goats. As a matter of fact, we only need two boas on the farm. So the rest pens will be receiving pens, where the young piglets will be moved into. So this is the walkway in the middle of the building. And by my right will be the weaner pens, and by my left will be the breeding pens. So that's the way it is designed. So this is just the construction phase. In fact, we are not even 40% into construction. We're just starting this project. So we want you to see it at this phase. So we'll bring back another video at the middle phase. Then after that, at the concluding phase. So you will see a step-by-step construction project process before the end of the project here in Ogun State, in Oke-Ore.
Oke-Ore, Ado Odoota local government.
Okay, Oke-Ore, Ota local government.
Ado Odoota.
Okay,
Ado Odoota.
Okay, Ado Odoota local government area. All right, that's okay. So basically, we are just constructing. Remember, what we are building here is 5,000 broilers capacity, 5,000 layers capacity, 200,000 capacity snail farm, both the concrete and the greenhouse system, and 3,000 capacity pig farm. So that's what we're building. So gradually we'll come back, and when things are clearer, we'll keep updating you on the project right here in Oke-Ore. So until we come your way again, thank you. The name remains Mr. Kester Amos. The number to reach us is +2348 068 525032. God bless you, and bye-bye.